McLaren have officially confirmed that they will make another three-seat hypercar. The Audi R8 exclusive edition shoots lasers out of its headlights. And this Ferrari LaFerrari is up for sale at an astonishing price. All that and more coming up right now on This Week in Cars. Hello, 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 car lovers worldwide, and welcome to This Week in Cars. After a few months of anxious anticipation and rumors, McLaren has finally officially announced that they'll be producing another three-seater Hyper GT, inspired by the McLaren F1. It's about time, McLaren. I've been waiting for this car my entire life. It will not actually be a successor to the McLaren F1, but it will be its own model inspired by the McLaren F1, and it is being codenamed BP23, which stands for Bespoke Project 2 3 Seats. And just in case you weren't aware, Bespoke Project 1 by MSO was the McLaren X1 concept displayed at the 2012 Pebble Beach Concours d'Elegance. Production will be capped at just 106 units to mirror the McLaren F1's production numbers, and McLaren CEO Mike Fluitt has confirmed that this car will also be a hypercar GT, which means that it will have a high hybrid powertrain. It will be one of the most powerful McLarens created to date, but this car will also deliver the highest level of refinement and comfort, enabling significant journeys to be undertaken with up to 3 passengers aboard. McLaren has unsurprisingly already begun design work on this car, and the actual deliveries won't begin until 2019. No official pricing figures have been released yet, but as the old saying goes, if you have to ask, you probably can't afford it. But from my interpretation, I expect that this car will probably start somewhere around $1 to $2 million. A brand new supercar has crashed in a high-speed incident in Italy, and the wreckage has left the car virtually unrecognizable. Can you tell what car this is? I'm just kidding, this car is obviously a Lamborghini Aventador SV, but due to how severe the damage is, this car looks like it's been torn apart. While details relating to this crash remain scarce, the photos reveal an intact passenger cell of this $500,000 Lamborghini that was torn into pieces, which thankfully means that nobody was severely injured. Reports suggest that the Italian supercar hit a guardrail at high speed before spinning out of control during the midday accident. Aside from the shock of the extent of this damage, my prayers as always go out to the owner of this car and anybody else affected by this travesty. And please remember to always drive safe and responsibly when you're out on the roads, no matter what car you're driving and how much horsepower it has. The Audi R8 V10 Plus Exclusive Edition was revealed this week at the LA Auto Show, and it will be limited to just 25 units only in the United States. This special edition Audi R8 can easily be identified by its quantum gray body color with solar orange stripes. If you look closely, however, you'll see the laser light's blue light signature within the headlight housing too. Yep, that's right, I said lasers. 4 high-intensity laser diodes in each headlight shoot a beam of blue laser light into a phosphor converter, which converts the blue light into a bright white shine, which can light up the road 600 meters ahead, twice that of an LED beam. Available for order now, the Audi R8 V10 Plus Exclusive Edition is modestly priced at $230,000, excluding destination charges, of course. This Rosso Corsa Ferrari LaFerrari is shockingly up for sale. But it's not really that shocking because we see LaFerraris for sale all the time, considering how much they've appreciated in value. But what is even more shocking about this car is the anticipated price point. With a base price of about $1.4 million straight from Ferrari, this same LaFerrari sold a while back for $3.8 million. And now, with just over 1,000 miles on the odometer, a dealer in Luxembourg has plonked a price tag of $10 million on this car. I mean, I don't mean to be rude, but who would pay $10 million for a LaFerrari? That's outrageous! Some people are speculating it's the first LaFerrari ever produced because it has the 1 out of 499 badge on the inside, but every LaFerrari has that. They didn't number their chassis, they just put 1 out of 499 for each LaFerrari. Every LaFerrari says 1 out of 499. And even if it was the first LaFerrari ever produced, I don't think that justifies a price this high. On the topic of insanely expensive car sales, a Koenigsegg 1:1 in the United States has recently sold for a whopping $10 million, the largest amount ever paid for a Koenigsegg before. This Koenigsegg is chassis number 112, and it is the last of just 7 total 1:1s ever built. And I think it's more understandable for this car to sell for $10 million rather than a LaFerrari. Producing about 1,360 horsepower, Koenigseggs are rapidly rising as some of the quickest, highest performing, and most desirable cars in the market. And with the Koenigsegg Regera soon to begin deliveries, the prices for Koenigseggs are bound to keep skyrocketing. Lastly, to finish off this episode, I have finally selected the winner of the 1 year anniversary of This Week in Cars giveaway. The winner will be receiving a 124th model of a McLaren P1 finished in Volcano Orange by Motormax. There she is, the winner of my first giveaway will be getting this model P1. And with that being said, the winner of my giveaway, the 1 year anniversary of This Week in Cars is... Roderick TJR 2003. Congratulations, please send me an Instagram DM to claim your prize. Thank you so much to everybody who entered in this giveaway. I really wish I could give you all something for participating and supporting me on this journey, but you all really do mean a lot to me, and I appreciate all of the support you guys have given me over this past year of This Week in Cars. And now, with this being the first episode of year 2 of This Week in Cars, I'm looking forward to everything that this year has in store for us. Ultimately, what it comes down to is I'm just glad that you all enjoy car news and talking about cars and automotive stories as much as I do, and I'm glad we can bond over that. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching another episode of This Week in Cars, and make sure to tune in again next Sunday for another update on news in the car world. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe for more. This has been Jake, and drive safe.